That is Canelo Zero now that Mayweather and Pacquiao are retired. What's your take on that?
What's that?
Teleo said that is Canelo Zero now that Mayweather and Pacquiao are retired. Is that true?
Well, the thing about, I used to argue with some promoters about this, who preferred Chavez Jr., for example, to Triple G in terms of a business. The thing about a business is you got to base it on someone who's blue chip, who's actually going to win some of the big fights. Like, say whatever you want about Oscar De La Hoya, he basically went even up with his entire era. They weren't better than him. I thought he beat Tito. He was close with Mosley twice. Floyd beat him, but it was near the end of Oscar's career, and it was competitive. He beat Vargas. He beat Corte. I mean, you know, he just fought everybody, but Oscar was a gold medalist, blue-chip fighter. Floyd, obviously, blue-chip fighter. Pacquiao, blue-chip fighter. Marvin Hagler, Sugar Ray Leonard, you know, these guys are all blue-chip fighters. You have to be blue chip. You can't just be a crowd-pleasing attraction if you want to be in business long-term as a top draw.
Does that apply to Triple G too, Max? Because he's not getting the big blue chip fighters, and he's building it off.
Triple G hasn't beaten anyone yet that we would consider, you know, would make him a great fighter. Should he's just annihilating that next tier. But he can't help it. He's fighting whoever they put in front of him.
If he can't land the Canelo, should he move up to fight a Ramirez at 68?
I think so. I think he should move up. He should fight the... Triple G is in a position where he should always fight the best available guy willing to fight him.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Secback.